Hello everyone. Pharmacy management helps you to manage retail pharmacy store. You can configure access rights for user and also for managers. You can configure medicine type, medicine category, manufacturing company, and also you can manage all the details about the medicines, customers, vendors, employees, and also employee contracts as well. You can create or manage sale order and purchase order details with medicines and required attachments of prescriptions. You can see a customer invoice report in the graph and pivot view, and also we have the print medicine expiry report in the PDF format. So let's start by creating a user and giving the access rights for the respected user. So for creating a user, we need to get into settings. Under user and companies, you can see and users. So from here, let's give an access to the Mitchell admin. Okay. So under user configuration, a Mitchell admin, like whether this particular person is in the admin, we can configure and pharmacy manager access for this particular user. So when we scroll down, you can see a pharmacy manager access will be provided. This gives and full access to the pharmacy, like it can configuration part is also enabled in the manager part. So if that particular person is a user, they can create the sale order, they can purchase the sale order, but there is a no option to confirm it. Okay, so let's see the process flow of the pharmacy management. So let's get into the pharmacy here. So after installing this module, you can see a menu named pharmacy management right away here. Manager can create a types of medicines. So for creating a medicine, you can just click on the configuration and you can see an medicine type. For before creating the medicine, we need to set up a medicine type as well as a medicine category as well. So let's get into a medicine type. Okay. So from here we can create a new medicine types. So if needed, you can just click on the new option to create a new one. Like the same way, we need to create a medicine category. So from here we need to create a medicine category, and manager can tick on the is prescription checkbox to require attachment for the prescriptions in the pharmacy sale order. So once everything is done, we can configure a manufacturing company. So for set up the manufacturing company, we need to get into the configurations. Under that, you can see a manufacturing company. So here I have created a sample companies. You can see in companies, and if needed, you can add a vendor list as well. So once everything is completed, let's create a pharmacy medicine. So for creating a medicine, we need to get into an inventory. Under products, you can see end products. So these are the medicines that we have created. Okay, so to create a new one, you can just click on the new option to create a new one. Let's get into one of the medicines that I have created. Manager can create a medicines from the product and then add the type. You can see a type here. And also they can add an a category. So they can add a category and also the expiry date as well. Okay. And other than that, we can mention the name, and here we can mention the internal notes for their clarifications, and also manufacturing company, expiry date, medicine type. So these are the informations that we can given for each and every medicine, and also the sales price and the cost price. Okay. So once everything is done, we have created the type or medicine type, we have created the category, and we have created a medicines as well. So the next one is we can create and pharmacy customers as well. So for creating and pharmacy customer, we need to get into and pharmacy management. Under that, you can see in sales. So here you can see and customers. So this is the customers which are already created. To create a new one, you can just click on the create option. That is a new option to create a new one. Here we can mention the basic information about the customers. Okay. And we can create an sale order from here itself. Like we need to get into a sales, and you can just click on the sale order to create a new sale order. That is, manager can create and manage details of the sales and sales order with the medicines and required attachments of the prescriptions. So let's create a new sale order here by clicking on the new option. And from here we can create a sale order by adding a customer name and the product. From here we need to add the product name. So this is the product which I have created. So let's create the product, and here we need in the attachments we can add the attachments of the prescriptions if needed. Okay, so let's save this one. And if need, once the sale order will be confirmed, you can just click on the confirm option to confirm it. If you need to send the sale order to that customer, you can just click on the send by mail option to send this particular sale order to the customer. Okay, so once everything is done, you can create an invoice from here itself. So from here you can create an invoice. So if needed, if everything is confirmed, you can just confirm it and you can register payment it, and you can pay the amount for that particular medicine. So like the same way, we have added an expiry date. So for that, let's create a new sale order. So this is the product which I have created. Okay, for this product the expiry date is today. So once I have added this product, if I try to confirm it, so it will show a warning. So it shows you can't confirm the order, some medicines have been in the expiry state. So this will give us a warning that we have chosen an expiry product. Okay, so once everything is done, we can create a sale order and create an invoice from here itself. Like the same way, we can create a purchase order and we can manage the vendors as well. So for pharmacy vendor, let's get into a purchase, and here you can see a vendors. So from here we can create a vendor by clicking on the new option. So from here we need to give all the informations about the vendors, and just by saving, you can save a new vendor, yeah, that you can create a new vendor. And then like the same way, we can create a purchase order. So from purchase you can see the purchase order, and for creating a new purchase order, you can just click on the new option to create a new purchase order. And from here we need to mention the vendor name, and in the products we need to add a product. Okay, so if it is a if it is the expiry product, you can add in product name and as well as the unit price of it. So let's confirm the order, and you can receive the products anytime we need. Okay, so now this quantity will be added into our stock. So let's create a bill from here itself. Vendor bill can also be created with along with the medicines. So from here I can confirm it. Let's add the bill date now, and let's confirm it, and let's pay the payment now. Okay, so now we have completed the purchase order till the bill completed. Okay, and then we have the other options, like we can create an pharmacy employees. Let's get into an employees. Under that you can see an employees menu. Manager can manage details of the pharmacy employees right away here. We can create the employees, and also we can create a contracts as well. Contracts for each and every employees. So for each and every employees, we created the contract, and you can see the status whether it is a new and how many of the employees having this contract is in the running state, and how many of them in the expired and also the cancelled state as well. Okay, now let's get into the reporting part. So in the reporting, we have the customer invoice analysis report. So let's get into that. Okay, so manager can see a customer sales invoice, that is customer's invoice analysis report, in the graph view as well as in the pivot view. Okay, for the pivot view is more consumable. You can customize it anytime you need. So from here I have customized like from partner, and we need to know the status of it. You can customize it and anytime you need, and you can add the same thing in the favorites too. Like the same way, we have the other reports like medicine expiry report. You can see an expiry report as well. We need to give a start date and end date. Okay, and let's print the report. Yeah, so it will show a list of products that a manager can see at the list of medicines, expiry medicines right away there. Okay, you can see this person, this particular medicine in the expiry state. You can see the expiry date as well. So in this way, we can efficiently manage the pharmacy management. Thank you for watching.